In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dearest mother and family, all those connected to the social means of communication, in a very special way, the Restrepo family, we have with us today in Jairo. On behalf of our whole spiritual religious family, our deepest condolences to you, as your mother has gone home to the Lord this last evening, that she will rest in peace. And we're offering this Holy Mass for her. Para que ella en paz descanse, recibe todas las bendiciones que Dios Padre quiere que ella reciba, que va a recibir a través de esta Santa Misa. Y para celebrar dignamente los sagrados misterios, reconozcamos nuestros pecados. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Let us pray. Listen kindly to our prayers, O Lord, as our faith in your Son, raised from the dead, is deepened. May our hope of resurrection for your departed servant, Gladys, also find new strength. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Those who had been scattered by the persecution that arose because of Stephen went as far as Phoenicia, Cyprus, and Antioch, preaching the word to no one but Jews. There were some Cypriots and Cyrenians among them, however, who came to Antioch and began to speak to the Greeks as well, proclaiming the Lord Jesus. The hand of the Lord was with them, and a great number who believed turned to the Lord. The news about them reached the ears of the church in Jerusalem, and they sent Barnabas to go to Antioch. When he arrived and saw the grace of God, he rejoiced and encouraged them all to remain faithful to the Lord in firmness of heart, for he was a good man filled with the Holy Spirit and faith, and a large number of people was added to the Lord. Then he went to Tarsus to look for Saul, and when he had found him, he brought him to Antioch. For a whole year they met with the church and taught a large number of people, and it was in Antioch that the disciples were first called Christians. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
To the psalm we respond, all you nations, praise the Lord.
All you nations, praise the Lord.
His foundation upon the holy mountains the Lord loves, the gates of Zion more than any dwelling of Jacob. Glorious things are said of you, O city of God.
All you nations, praise the Lord.
I tell of Egypt and Babylon, among those who know the Lord, of Philistia, Tyre, Ethiopia. This man was born there, and of Zion they shall say, one and all were born in her, and he who has established her is the Most High Lord.
All you nations, praise the Lord.
They shall know when the peoples are enrolled, this man was born there, and all shall sing in their festive dance, my home is within you.
All you nations, praise the Lord.
Says the Lord, I know them and they follow me.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The feast of the dedication was taking place in Jerusalem. It was winter. And Jesus walked about in the temple area on the portico of Solomon. So the Jews gathered around him and said to him, "How long are you going to keep us in suspense? If you are the Christ, tell us plainly." Jesus answered them, "I told you, and you do not believe. The works I do in my Father's name testify to me, but you do not believe, because you are not among my sheep. My sheep hear my voice. I know them, and they follow me. I give them eternal life, and they shall never perish. No one can take them out of my hand. My Father, who has given them to me, is greater than all, and no one can take them out of the Father's hand. The Father and I are one." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon, Father.
The Scriptures are always so encouraging, inspiring, and they console us too. Something extraordinary was happening in Antioch, contemporary Syria, and Barnabas is sent from Jerusalem to find out what it is. And as Greek-speaking Jews begin to share about Christ, there are Gentiles that begin to understand the gospel that's being translated now for the first time in the native language of the Eastern Roman Empire, the same language with which the whole New Testament will be written in biblical Greek. And as they hear about Christ, many want to receive the sacraments. They want to be baptized. They want to be liberated from the oppression and darkness that is upon them. And Barnabas, who is a man filled with grace and the Holy Spirit and an encourager, Barnabas means son of encouragement, he is inspired by the Holy Spirit. How am I going to teach the Gentiles the faith? I mean, they don't know anything about anything, and they're lost with everything. And the Holy Spirit put on Barnabas' heart to go find Saul of Tarsus. Imagine that. According to the chronology of Acts of the Apostles, we're in chapter 11 now. In the next chapter, Peter and James will be in prison. James will be in prison by Archelaus, and he will be put to death. And then they imprison Peter. And after the imprisonment, Archelaus dies a tragic death. And so his death, which is recorded in the Roman annals, becomes a marker for the time that James was martyred. And James is martyred right before St. Paul, after spending a year in Antioch, goes to Jerusalem. It means that we're in the year 43 AD. It has been 10 years since the resurrection. St. Paul has had his incredible conversion on the road to Damascus, 3 years in Arabia, then he goes back, he preaches the word, he goes down to Jerusalem, and the result of being in Jerusalem is that everybody is ready to kill Saul. And what does Peter do? He sends him home. It says they took him to maritime Caesarea, put him on a boat, and that was it. The church had no idea what to do with Paul. Until now. And so it was Barnabas who brings Saul back to Antioch, and they preach for a year. And they're encountering the marvels of the Lord, that all that has happened upon them and the Jewish people, it's happening in the lives of the Gentiles. The Gentiles are being baptized. They're believing in Christ. They're learning the commandments, and they're walking in the way of the Lord. And this is something that has never happened before. Jew and Gentile together. Are you going to call them Jews? Are you going to call them Greek God-fearers? That's what they're called in the synagogue. No, they had to be called something else. And what do you call this new family of faith formed by Jew and Gentile, something that previously was totally impossible? Well, they were called Christians. For the first time, the word is given to those that are baptized into Christ, that live in Christ and live for Christ. And what is the fundamental gift for the Christian? Jesus reveals it in the gospel today. John chapter 10, the feast of the dedication of the altar, the feast of Hanukkah in the winter. And he says that all of us are in his hands. You see, these hands that were pierced on the cross, these hands that were open wide for us, and they were stayed to the wood, but for him, they were the hands that would embrace each one of us for all time. And the Christian is the one who belongs to Christ. And how do you describe belonging to someone better than saying that we're held in the palm of his hand? Jesus holds us in the palm of his hand. How many times would he say in Scripture, be not afraid? Why? Because he holds us in the palm of his hand. What about the moments of suffering and indecision? Well, don't let that disturb you, because I'm with you always until the close of the age, because I hold you in the palm of my hand. Today we're also encouraged that Jesus is always faithful to his promises, and that Jairo's mother, Gladys, is held in the palms of the hand of Jesus. Those hands that were pierced for us on the cross, those hands that invite us into the wound of his pierced heart, which is the fount of salvation, and the other hand, which simply blesses us. The hand that brings us home, and the hand that protects us and blesses us in this life and the next, because we are in the palm of his hand. Let us remember that no matter what the occasion or the circumstance, from this life to the next, we belong to Christ, which means we're Christians, those that are held in the palm of the hand of Jesus. Let us conclude with these words of our Mother Foundress. This love of God, this eternal love, this imperishable love is the only love that is capable of guaranteeing man of his happiness, because it is the only love that excludes all fear of losing the beloved. For God holds us in the palm of his hands. All for the heart of Jesus.
Through the heart of Mary.
Dearest mother and family, all those connected to the social means of communication, trusting that we abide in the palms of the hands of the Father, we present our prayers and petitions.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For the Church, for our Pope, for Archbishop Thomas Wenski, for the Cardinal Patriarch of Jerusalem and his protection, and for all the bishops in the diocese where we serve and will serve, we pray to the Lord. For our Mother Foundress, in profound thanksgiving, for not sparing in anything to love to the extreme, we pray for her physical and spiritual protection, for all of her discernments, health, and intentions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our religious, spiritual, and biological families, for the health of Sister Carmen and the efficaciousness of her treatments, for the health of Sister Alyssa and Sister Samantha, for our protection, for our sisters in Paraguay, for our Veritatis Splendor Institute, in the course Thy Kingdom Come, for the young knights of the pierced hearts and the young ladies of Our Lady, and for the fecundity of all of our apostolic works, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For an increase of healthy vocations to masculine and feminine religious life, for the final permits for Our Lady of Nazareth Novitiate House, for our vocational groups Go to Joseph, Heart of John, and Nazareth, and for all the young men and women discerning with our religious family, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For an increase of vocations to the priesthood in our archdiocese, for St. Vincent de Paul Major Seminary, its mission, seminarians, and faculty, for the University of Mary, Catholic Distance University, and Augustine Institute, for the protection of Grand Canyon University, for Father Brian, the priest and parishioners of St. Michael the Archangel Parish, in the Archdiocese of Kansas City, and for the Acts 29 ministry, Paradisus Dei, and Shot communities, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
In thanksgiving for all of our benefactors, for their protection, intentions, and their families, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
for the end to all forms of violence, for peace in the entire world, for the protection of all soldiers, especially Jacob Martinez, Gabriel Soñé, Peter John Jude, Fernando Labrada, for all innocent civilians and protection of sacred places, for the health of all babies, especially for Heleni Orna, Victoria Ruiz, Ella Filomena, Alexander, Alejandra's baby, and Mariano, for the protection of all children and adolescents from human trafficking, for the end to religious persecution, and for the protection of the world from war, economic recession, corruption, and natural disasters, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who entrust themselves to our prayers, we ask Our Lady that she may fill Jairo Restrepo and all of his family with her love, and that the Lord may receive dear Gladys in his merciful embrace. We pray for the intentions of Priscilla, Miriam, Patricia, Pablo, Luis, Guillermo, Julia, Mario, Antonio, Ana Maria, Maria Jose, Maria Paz, y Alexandra. For the pregnancies of Noel Curry, Cassandra, Dominique, Milena, Marianne, Rebecca, Marinela, Gloria, Annie, Michelle, Camila, Maria Jose, Josefina, Kelly, Chiara, Carelis, Mia, Alejandra, Daniela, Alisa, Maria, Meredith. For the health of all the sick, especially for Margarita, Esteban, Sharon, Nieve, Sergio, Olga, Pablo, Ninfa, Luigi, Amalia, Ricardo, Jose, Dr. Carlos, Manolo, Maria Luisa, Jose, Heidi, Stella, Doña Julia, Maya, Maximiliano, Evangelina, Jose, Tere, Maria, Felix, Carlos, Clayton, Zulay, Ilina, Kate, Todd, Socorro, Diácono Vicente, Henry, Tere, Camila, Mayrita, Diego, Jorge, Consuelo, Ofelia, Geisa, Aurelio, Ibis, Marilu, Leo, Joe. And for the souls of our deceased benefactors, for the souls in purgatory, and for the eternal repose of all the faithful departed, especially for Gladys Restrepo, Jorge Raúl Garcete, Euro Muñoz, and Irma Menéndez, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We also remember Andy Downey. We pray Our Lady to be with him as he prepares to encounter the Lord. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious Father, you are rich in mercy. Help us to walk in that freedom of knowing we are always held in the palm of your hand. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen. Our offertory hymn will be number 19 in the English section.
I will never forget.
pray, dearest family, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant we pray that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Holy,
holy, holy, holy Lord,
God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Hosanna
in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Thomas our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember your servant Gladys, whom you have called today from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, especially Bishop Peter Muick, Gladys, Jorge Raul, Euro, Melly, Flor, Irma, Raul, Chris, Gloria, Ali, Teresa, Hans, Jorge, Ronald, Angela, Anita, Pat, Miriam, Jeff, Dr. Marcelino Gatto, Carmen, Russell, Thomas, Andrew, Brent, Danny, Mariano, Dolores, Leonel, Georgina, Bill, Jack, Paul, Caleb, and Michael. For the souls of our deceased benefactors, the souls in purgatory, the souls of those who have died tragically, unexpectedly, and from war. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer to each other the sign of peace. Peace, my
brother. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion hymn will be number 100 in the bilingual section.
when you eat my body and you drink my blood, I will live in you and you will live in my love. When you eat my body and you drink my blood, I will live in you and you will live in my love. We are one body, one body in Christ, and we do not stand alone. We are one body, one body in Christ, and he came that we might have life. For he tells us, I am the way, the truth, the life. I am the final sacrifice. I am the way, the truth, the life. He who believes in me will have eternal life. I am the way, the truth, the life. I am the final sacrifice. I am the way, the truth, the life. He who believes in me will have eternal life. Church I build, come receive my spirit with my gifts be filled. For you are my body, you're my hands and feet. Speak the word of life to everyone you meet. We are one body in Christ, and we do not stand alone.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your servant Gladys, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with you.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Pedimos a San Miguel Arcángel que nos proteja de todos los males espirituales, físicos, morales, naturales, relacionales. De manera especial pedimos por Gladys, por Irma, por todos los difuntos de nuestra familia. Pedimos que por la intercesión de San Miguel estén ya ante la presencia de Dios. Pedimos también que San Miguel vaya delante de nosotros con su espada, abriéndonos caminos, disipando toda oscuridad y abriendo los caminos de la luz y de la providencia divina. San Miguel Arcángel,
defiéndenos en la batalla, sé nuestro amparo contra la perversidad y acechanzas del demonio. Reprima de Dios, pedimos suplicantes, y tú, príncipe de la milicia celestial, arroja al infierno con el divino poder a Satanás y a los otros espíritus malignos que andan dispersos por el mundo para la perdición de las almas.
Recibir la bendición con el Santísimo. Pidamos al Señor, el buen pastor, que siempre sepamos escuchar su voz, ir tras de él, cumplir su voluntad y darle espacio para todos los triunfos de su corazón y el corazón de su madre.